I see your gums. Do you guys remember record stores?
Yeah.
I still go to them, actually. But there was this coolest little record store in Lexington, Massachusetts called Overall Music. And they had this great Saturday afternoon concert series that they even let me sing in. And it was run by this very sweet woman named Ellen Epstein. And it turns out that she is a great singer herself. And for the past 30 years, she has been singing with Cindy Kallet and Michael Cicone. And when we had, the idea of doing this concert and doing it in Boston, you know, I thought very early on of calling up Ellen, and I did, and she said, well, you know, Cindy moved to Indiana. And I said, well, think about it. So I got a call back a couple days later saying, you know, Ellen had talked to Cindy, and Cindy had talked to Michael, and Michael had talked to Ellen, and please welcome to the stage one of the premier folk harmony groups in New England, Kallet-Epstein-Cicone. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for remembering my little music store, Terry.
All right. This has been a treasure of a night. We are so thrilled to hear everybody that has been playing. It's just exquisite, exquisite music. This is a song, it doesn't really have a title. I made it up at the very end of October 2016, and it wasn't meant as a political song, it was just meant as a, this is how I'm feeling and I'm going to write it down song. And I thought it would have a short shelf life.
They were putting down when we were shouting over, tell me what did we not see today? The radio blaring loud, the TV screaming out, what did we not see today? I didn't see vermilion sky, nor stallion clouds all hurtling west. No jewel tree in dapple dress. I didn't salute the autumn flags, those seed pods bold and brave. I didn't feel the rain. When they were rattling, whining, screaming, talking under, tell me what did we not hear today? Tumult and tearing, carcass wheeling and dealing plunder, what did we not see today? I didn't spy the waggling wren, nor chortle and gaggling gangs of cranes. No dew in leafy glade. I didn't kneel at the rising moon with rainbow mist in the grassy ground. When they were jabbing, jibing, filling the air with fury, what did we not choose today? All of the pushing, prying, making up stories, lying, what did we not do today?
See the tiny child wrapped in weary arms, no home safe and warm. And I didn't feel the rising seas as we went streaming by. Higher, richer, dry. And I didn't see the millions more streaming across the land. Thank you.
Turn off the noise so I can see you. Now in the quiet night I'll hear you. Then I can hold both pain and soft light, burning of tears and bright eyes.
This next song is by Grit Laskin, and I think it poses a kind of a conundrum or a question that each of us does or doesn't face in our lives, but we kind of have to think about it, I think. I had no say in being born, or where or when it happened to me. It's only chance that turned the wheel and made my living easy. Oh, I am a lucky man, favored by good fortune's hand, far more than I deserve. I've had good work since I was young, mastered a trade, my business thriving. Yet thousands idly bide their days, no job means no surviving. Oh, I am a lucky man, favored by good fortune's hand, far more than I deserve. I share a love that's fair and true, a marriage have I that's rich with pleasure. Yet there are those whose wedding vows are shackles that embitter. Oh, I am a lucky man, favored by good fortune's hand, far more than I'm deserving. Some who die for want of bread, there's some are killed for seeking freedom. Yet I have more of what they crave than ever I'll be near. Oh, I am a lucky man, favored by good fortune's hand, far more than I had no say in being born, or where turned the wheel and made my living easy. Oh, I am a lucky man, favored by good fortune's hand, far more than I deserve.
This next song, I was thinking last summer, I was thinking about the people in, I was remembering that in the winter of last year, there had been stories of people going up through northern New York, Maine, and walking barefoot into Canada to get out of this country, and because they were worried, they were afraid. And I also was, I've loved some of the Irish ballads, some of the songs of emigration that all talk about coming to America. And so I took that kind of a style of accompaniment and melody and made this song. It's called Letter to America. Twice broken from my home. We are tired, we are huddled poor, with nowhere else to go. Washed ashore on gasoline soaked rafts, months parched on desert sands, cross barbed wire walls, border's path, for just a nest of land. Ourselves in your country's worth, our families are yours.
beside the golden door, the true land of the free, across the snows of America. It's Canada I see, it's Canada I see.
I forgot to preface that song by saying I love my country very much, and I also went and looked at the Statue of Liberty poem. Obviously, it's part of the inspiration for that. Anyway, we are going to sing one more song,
and it's by a Canadian songwriter named Susan Ellington. It's called "Shine On."
Shine on, shine on, silver moon. Love is gone, love will be back soon. For the new moon and are the same moon after all, and the heart is always full. Freedom, freedom in my soul, destiny out my control. When my freedom and my destiny look each other in the face, feels like life lived in grace. So shine. Shine on, silver moon. Love is gone. Love will be back soon. For the new moon and the old moon are the same moon after all. And the heart is always full. Children laughing in the sun, old men, old women come undone. When the new ones and the old ones look each other in eyes, feels like love never dies. So shine on, shine on, silver moon. Love is gone,
Cindy Kallet, Kallet-Epstein, Michael Cicone. What a pleasure, what a pleasure. And we didn't even have to go to Indiana to hear them. A few years ago, PMN started a tradition of having what's called the artist in residence at every gathering, someone who's really established in their field to be there as sort of a resource to do some teaching and answer questions and share their music. And we were so lucky that this gathering, we're actually gonna have two artists in residences. One of them, Charlie King, unfortunately, is not feeling at his best, so he's resting tonight so he can be there to teach us tomorrow. But luckily, we had the forethought to get two, so. Tom?
Rick Burqhardt is joining us this evening. He's an Obie Award-winning playwright, a performer, songwriter, whose works have been performed throughout the world. He's a founding member of the Nonsense Company. I want to be in the Nonsense Company. That's an experimental music theater trio. And the Prince Myshkins, who released two acclaimed CDs and performed Coast to Coast from 1997 to 2010. This evening, joining Rick is Jermaine Golden. Please welcome him.
Hello.
Hey.
Hi. So we are Charlie King.
You can be Charlie, I'll be King.
All right, that sounds reasonable. I've never really we talked a lot about traditional music. I have always wanted to write songs which would ideally go out of date as soon as possible. That would be the perfect fate for any topic that I take on. Tonight, for the very first time, though, I had the experience of hoping that one of my songs lasts for about 200 years so that Windborne will perform it. Oh my God, that was good. So, it's been great. This has been a great evening. All this amazing music, all these amazing messages, a lot of really inspiring stuff. And it's good to be inspired. It's a useful emotional state to be in. One can often do a lot of great things. One can participate in activism, one can participate in community organizing when one is inspired, but it's important to remember that one can also do those things when one is crotchety and irritable. And that's a little bit of what this song is about. So Kate calls me up from her job at the food court, one pita pouch away from flying off the handle, cause the food court is playing this corporate college radio station. And Kate's not allowed to turn it off or change the channel. And according to Kate, who is not known for hyperbole, she's heard the same six songs like 15 times tonight. And every single one of those songs has made a special point of telling her in every single chorus that it's all right. Oh, it's all right, baby, it's all right. Down at the food court, you can see why they're annoyed. Kate says, what's all right? Can you prove it's all right? Say it one more time, and I just might get paranoid. Cause it's not all right. It's not all right. It's not even slightly all right. And I don't blame it. It's not all right. No, it's not all right. It doesn't matter how you paint it or who you hire to frame it. You name it, it's not all right. One could interpret that as a sing-along chorus. Up from his shift at the airport after 9+ hours on the verge of going ballistic, because I got this unmutable television playing this unmutable politician who keeps telling Kyle that Kyle's inspired and optimistic.
My opponent says you're angry. My opponent says you're bitter. Well, that may be what my opponent believes, but I know you're resilient. You're hardworking and cheerful. You're looking to the future, and oh, you're rolling up your sleeves.
Rolling up our sleeves. Did he say rolling up our sleeves? Did I just going nuts, or was that what you heard him say? My life is an assembly line, I've got no health insurance, and now this millionaire is telling me it's casual day. It's not alright, it's not alright. I'm not buying it, no matter how enticingly you price it. It's not alright, it's not alright. You can edit it and splice it, but any way you slice it, think twice, it's not all right. And now the emperor's appearing every night on every station, wearing his traditional imperial regalia, which means not only does he have no clothes on whatsoever, he also seems to have no genitalia. He says the war is going great, and we're not committing torture. And if we are, we're saving you from terrorist attacks. And food is getting cheaper, and the climate isn't changing. And Americans aren't racists anymore, except for blacks. And prominent economists agree that all we have to do to strengthen our economy is keep saying it's strong. And Americans are happy, and the whole world loves us. And our only real problem is our sleeves are too long. It's not all right, it's not all right. Oh, the emperor can shove it up his thousand points of light, tell that nattering nudist to take it with him when he leaves town. Roll your sleeves down, it's not all right. No, it's not all right, it's not all right. Come on, America, please stop being such a good sport. Just imagine if this song was playing at the food court or on the TVs in the airport. It's not all right. We're Rick and Jermaine, and this message has our support. In short, it's not all right.
Rick, Rick. I think they're awake. You guys, way to come out and stay for this long night of incredible music, and you know, thank you for welcoming me. I didn't have like a bio or anything, but I had the pleasure of touring with both of the artists in residence this fall around New England. I got invited. Rick and I have been collaborators for years and years and years, and I got to meet Charlie and sing some of his incredible music, and so I am happy to be here and to be back. You know, thank you, representing, and yeah, this is my first PMN, so I'm stoked. Thank you, guys. Yeah.
The moment you step in a street, you've stepped in before. The moment the squad car opens its door. The moment your hands go up in the air and you go down. A moment of silence. The moment you first tell your kids, look out for the cops. The moment the cops all show up, dressed like Gestapo. The moment it looks like the war overseas, but it's your hometown. Of silence for Michael Brown. The moment the anchorman calls you a thug, The moment they ask why your family and friends can't take it lying down. A moment of silence. For some of the folks we've recently learned we're sharing this country with.
In 1861, our legacy begun. We heard the call of Dixie's horn. We boldly took up arms against those who do us harm. And so our Confederacy was born. We marched behind our General Lee to keep specific people free, and in our finest hour we made our best contribution to history. We lost.
We got our dentures flossed. They put us in the microwave and left us on defrost. We were liquefied, battered, fried, set aside, and sauced.
Ew.
Then they ate us up for breakfast and billed us for the cost. We were creamed. We got our keisters reamed. History left us in the dust, breathing its exhaust. And when the war was o'er, we were used to mop the floor. We were trumped. We were whumped. We lost. It was the most heroic thing we could have done. Oh, just think if we had won. How strange that we have seen in 2017 our cause embraced by all you fools. Those uniforms you've polished in which we were demolished. Do you seriously think wearing those is cool? Your noble tradition of historical revision is not what we would recommend. But fine, show your forces, trot out your tiki torches, and we can tell you how it's going to end. You'll lose,
you'll leave a trail of ooze. Who knows what they'll use to scrape shoes. Soon you'll be so few, they'll be breeding you in zoos. We'll give you some advice, which is don't read your reviews. You'll fail
on an unimpressive scale. Please confirm receipt of your asses in the mail. And
just like the guys you absurdly idolize, you will learn how it feels to live up to these ideals. You'll be beached, you'll be bleached, your potential will be reached. You'll be punked, you'll be skunked, you'll be lifetime bottom bunked. You'll be thrust in the dust with your musket snuffed with rust. You'll be just like us.
Still thrives in the American folk song. So we thought we might do a song by Charlie King.
Cause yeah, right? He should be. He's here with us all right now. He is.
I mean. And he's not contagious.
Oh, God.
That's amazing.
This is one of my very favorite Charlie King songs. In fact, it's one of my very favorite songs at all. Charlie wrote this song about 10 years ago, and the first time I heard it, I was like, okay, masterpiece, good. And then this last tour that Jermaine was talking about, I was like, Charlie, we should do that song of yours. And he was like, oh, I forgot all about that song. And I was like, what? You can't do it. So, this is that song.
A. Philip Randolph, born in 1889, just 23 years after Congress finally freed the slaves. He organized the Brotherhood of Sleeping Car Porters back when organizing unions was a fast track to the grave. Old Man Pullman tried to bribe him with a blank check and a letter. Said it's good to seven figures soon as you and I agree. Randolph sent the check back with a note that stated simply, you could buy my parents, but you can't buy me. You can't buy me, no, you can't buy me. You can own the government, make the laws and pick the president, but the last word in the argument is you can't buy me.
The amazing thing is that this song just gets better from there. Natalia Dmitrich of Ukrainia State TV was a signer for the deaf on the 6 o'clock news. When the anchorman said, candidate Yushchenko is the loser, he assumed she would report that, but she silently refused. The results are rigged, she signed instead. Please do not believe them. I will not interpret lies. Perhaps the truth will set us free. She sparked a general walkout of journalists by saying, you may own the media, but you don't own me.
You don't own me. No, you don't own me. Government, make the laws and pick the president, but the last word in the argument is you don't own me. One person at the bottom stands in solitary witness, like Rosa Parks believing segregation could be stopped. The underdogs who fought him know the emperor is witless. When the system comes apart, it will unravel from the top.
I don't even know her name. An old woman on the sidewalk, downtown Kansas City, on the first day of the war. Her sign must have been 4 feet tall, stating her position. And though passing drivers cursed her, her words could not be ignored. God bless the people of Iraq. The message she had written made me think of them as friends and not some faceless enemy. And having no illusions that her sign would end the slaughter, she said, I may not stop this system, but it won't stop me.
It won't stop me, no, it won't stop me. Oh, it may own the government, make the laws and pick the president, but the last word in the argument is it won't stop me. Because you can't buy me, no, you can't buy me. The last word in the argument, you can't buy.
Thank you. We're just going to play one more song. Do you all know John Fromer?
Yes.
Of course you do.
Yes.
Come on. So some of you know this song. If you don't, you will soon. And this is definitely a sing-along song, and it goes like this. My feet are tired.
My feet are tired.
My feet are tired.
My feet are tired.
I said my feet.
Tired,
but like Ike. You remember Jim Crow? A bus in Montgomery, southern town. That woman started something when she sat down. My feet are tired.
My feet are tired.
My feet are tired. Streets at night, every day for a week, every week for a month. It took more than a year before it was done. I feel a tie. You'd have been there, you'd have heard people say, always hoped my kids would see a better day. Lately I think I've changed my mind. I want to see freedom in my time.
Thank you. To say. That was Jermaine. I'm Rick. Bye.